gonna find them all.
Physics in video games are crazy. Sometimes physics are just decent, and sometimes physics are the main point of the game that you're playing. Now, I remember like 10 years ago, having physics in your game was huge. I mean, there was entire people who would play games just to play with the physics engine. When I was 9, I wasn't playing GTA 4 for fun. I was playing it because you could do this shit. That's cool. It's just a little weird how fast the cutting edge becomes normalcy. If you look at something like Overwatch, the amount of physics simulations that some of these weapons and animations have are ridiculous. They'd probably break your computer if this was 2004. From like 2001 to like 2009, people were going ham on physics. You had Half-Life 1, you had Half-Life 2, you had Red Faction, you had Crysis, you had Battlefield, and then everyone just kind of stopped. Now, I don't want to put any blame on GTA specifically, but damn, man, it was heartbreaking to load up GTA 5 and realize that the physics were, they were just okay. The normalization and the fact that physics are kind of just a standard in every game and every game engine kind of means people don't really have to innovate anymore. No one's using Euphoria. No one's doing anything. Probably one of the best examples of this is Crobcat's recent video where he showed the differences between Left 4 Dead 2 and Back 4 Blood. Now, modern AAA games are just not going to be up to snuff with the physics engines of like 2009, and that's just a cold hard fact. And it seems like modern games just get more and more overly competitive for no reason. In CSGO, it makes sense that the player character is not interrupted by physics at any moment until he dies. Now, this makes no sense in Back 4 Blood, which is a co-op shooter. Let's look at Half-Life 2. Now, the player is completely unfazed by physics. This guy is a solid piece of meat, alright? But the levels are entirely based around physics. So how do you solve the disconnect between a stoic player and a physics-based level? You give them a gun that literally acts as a vessel between one and the other. It's genius. Now, Half-Life Alyx is awesome. This is one of my favorite games ever. But the disconnect between the player and the level in this game is so crazy. You're basically a ghost running around this big sandbox of insane cutting-edge physics. It's kind of ridiculous. This is why it's really weird to me that people always bring up Half-Life Alyx and Boneworks in the same sentence. Both of them have very different physics engines, and both of them have very different rules for how the player can actually interact with the environment. They're not the same at all. If that doesn't tell you the state of physics engines in games in 2021, then I don't know what does. If even Valve is going the safe route and just making the player float around the map like it's nothing, I don't know what to tell you. I guess we're doomed that we're never going to have good physics engines ever again. Back in the day, you had to really want to have physics interactions in your game. It wasn't something that happened by accident, and most of the times it was a Herculean task to even get it working. Now it's one button in Unity, and somehow it's worse than it's ever been. Why? Money. Un día y se enamoró más de mí y de esta belleza. ¡Vámonos! ¡Cuán, cuán, 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 cuán!
Ya está cerrada con tres candados. Y remachada la puerta negra.
Yo, I want the video length to be 420, so don't watch this part.